Hello everyone, I am Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. This is fourth tutorial of STAAD.Pro, and in this tutorial we are going to learn another method of creating a structure, and that is run structure wizard method. To get this, you have to go to the menu bar and click on geometry option. Then come to the last option, there is run structure wizard. Click on this and you will get a window. There are a lot of ready-made models of structures in STAAD.Pro. You can modify and use them. This window consists of a lot of prototype models. If you click on this arrow, you will see a lot of models here. Let's first choose the truss models. Under truss models, there are 6 models of truss. If you want to view this structures, then you have to double click on this icon, or you can select and drag and drop on this white area, then a window will pop up. There is some properties of your structure, you can modify them. Now I am viewing this lattice truss with these default properties and clicking on apply. Then I got a structure which is lattice truss, and you can view it from any direction, or you can try pad truss. I'm keeping all these default and clicking on apply, and your model is ready in 1 second. Now let's view other samples. So these are the truss models, and there are others models also. For that you have to click on this arrow. If you want to get building models, you have to click on this frame models. If you click on this, then you will get some models for your buildings. Bay frame, which is mostly used for buildings. Every building has a height, a length and width. You can change these properties from this box. And here number of bays means number of portions of that length. If you want to divide the length 12 meter by 4 portions, then you will input here 4. Similarly, you can divide the height by number of portions that you want. For now, I'm keeping all these default and clicking on apply. Then I got my building structure. Now the question is how to take this model to our workspace. There are 3 ways to take this structure in our workspace. If you close this window, then there will be a notification, then you will click OK, then this structure will be pasted on your workspace. Or you can go to file, then you have a option merge model with STAAD.Pro model. By clicking on this option, you can take this structure to your main workspace. Or you can go to edit option, then here there is option add or paste model in STAAD.Pro. I'm clicking on this option, then there a window pop up. I have to click on yes, then I have to give a point where I want to put this model. In our workspace there is a origin that is 0, 0 and 0. If I give this point as my origin, then that origin of that model will coincide with our main origin of our workspace. So I click OK. Now just disable the default grid so that I can view my structure nicely. In last tutorial we drew our continuous beam with the help of coordinate method, but today I am going to draw that by run structure wizard. For that I have to go to the menu bar and click on geometry option, then go to run structure wizard, then I will click the frame models, then here there is continuous beam. I am double clicking on it. The total length of that continuous beam was 20.7, and there were 2 beams, that's why I have to divide this length by 2 bays, and I am giving here 2. Before applying, I have to check this 3 dot. Here they have divided that total length by equal length, but my beams are not equal, so I have to give here 10.25 and here 10.45. then click OK, then apply. Then I have gotten my continuous beam by run structure wizard, and now I want to take it to my main workspace. That's why I have to close it. Then a window will pop up. I will click on X. then I have to give a point where I want to paste it. You can choose any point with your mouse cursor. If you don't want to input any point, then you have to use this reference point. I'm clicking on it. I'm clicking on OK. Then I have to click on a point where I want to paste that point. So I'm clicking on this node and I'm clicking OK. Then again OK. Then see, I am getting my beam in my workspace also. Like this, you can combine multiple structures in your workspace. If I close it, then all informations of your nodes and your beams is being displayed in these two tables here. You can modify your structure from these tables also. I want to view my other structures of run structure wizard. That's why I'm clicking on geometry, then clicking on run structure wizard. Then I'm going to frame models. Then here it is floor grid. By this model you will get only plan of your building, not any structure. Click on apply, then see only the floor is being displayed here. Again, there is cylindrical frame also. You can view it by like this, and you can see the cylindrical frame, and you can also modify it when you get that starting window. You can change the properties as you want and you will get your cylindrical frame. So we can use our ready-made models of our structures from run structure wizard. And this is all for today. If you find any kind of trouble or problems, then comment below, or you can use the email address that I have given to description.